Welcome to lecture 2 of thermomechanical processing of materials. In this lecture I am going to speak about what are the conventional thermomechanical process and non-conventional thermomechanical processes. Conventional thermomechanical processes are divided mainly based on the compression strain. During the deformation, you mean plastic deformation process, type of compression strains are applied during hot rolling process, during hot forging process, during hot extrusion process. Hot rolling process are, there are rolls, top rolls and bottom rolls exist. In between, the material to deform is allowed to pass. So it reduces the cross-sectional area. Similarly, hot forgings, if you want to convert the ingot or billet into a bowl, so you apply at a above recrystallization temperature of the material, applying the compression stress with the technique called forging, and you will produce a bowl. And hot extrusion process, you will take a kind of a billet and subject it to the extrusion process in a die, and you extrude and convert into the pipe some dimensions of pipes or tubes. That is an example for the hot extrusion process. These falls under the category of conventional TMP process. Now coming to the non-conventional thermomechanical processes. Non-conventional thermomechanical processes are as followed, and these are divided based on the shear strain applied. Predominantly, essentially, the shear strains are applied during the plastic deformation in these processes. One of the example, E-cap, equal channel angular pressing. You will provide a die with a equal channel kind of a pipe and angular, the from the top and from the x-axis, with respect to the x-axis and y-axis, these are arranged with the orthogonal angle, you mean 90 degrees. So when you are providing input material and output material, entry and exit will not lose the dimensional change, you mean just like in the case of hot rolling process, cross-sectional area changes, whereas in the case of equal channel angular pressing or equal channel angular extrusion process, it has other name, and you will be getting a product without changing the cross-sectional area, and you can provide the severe plastic deformation, you mean higher strains can be developed to change dimension of the input material. And this particular process is mainly developed to refine the grain structure from the large grain structure to ultra fine grain structure. Similarly, another process, ARB, accumulative roll bonding process. You will be using rolls, bottom and top rolls. In between, you use multiple sheets, accumulate with the multiple sheets. Finally, you bond into the single solid material. So there also severe plastic deformations are achieved, higher strains are achieved, you will convert. So in the requirement of those kind of bonding, so are done using this process. And HPT, high pressure torsions. In the case of torsion, one of the anvil is kept fixed, the other one is rotated anti-clockwise direction, so that applying the higher pressure you can develop the strains and plastically you can deform. And multi-axial forging. So for example, a material is having the three dimensions. All three dimensions you can provide the forging process, compression, all three directions. So in another words, it becomes kind of shear process, multi-axial, x direction, y direction, z direction. Whereas in the case of hot forging, only z direction you are applying the compression strain. So here you have the provision of all the directions, x, y and z direction. And another process is friction stir processing, which will be discussed as a last point. Friction stir processing, so in the case of, this is nothing but a localized plastic deformation you can subject, which is quite possible in the case of friction stir processing. It has another prerequisite, friction stir welding. You can weld in a solid state at a cold working temperature. You can weld to similar metals, just like aluminium, you can weld, developing the fusion, reaching to the ultimate temperature by friction from the top pin, which is rotated, and the bottom anvil is fixed, where the sample is being fixed using a standard metal die fixtures, and you apply the stirring and you weld it. And processing is nothing but if you want to adapt another alloying element such as powders in between these particular two similar metals, you can add powder and you can stir it so that it mix together. You can develop another processed alloy, so which is nothing but friction stir processing, which is applying shear only, friction means. Now, so let us discuss about the physical simulations, how important are the physical simulations for TMP process. For the industry, you cannot develop or you cannot repeat all the experiments for understanding the concepts or standardizing the process parameters, one of the TMP process. You cannot always perform the, when you are changing the design and dimensions, you cannot change the physical setup. So for that you require a simulation setup or modeling setup. So for those things, initially you need lab scale experiments to be performed. For example, compression test, a conventional thermomechanical process. Severe plastic deformation, such as examples ECAP, ARB process, which is non-conventional thermomechanical process. These are conducted at a different temperature, strains and strain rates. You have data, output data, so at these parameters, and you will develop a model with a constant equation, and this particular data is required. So which was coming from the physical simulations. These are the physical experiments at the laboratory scale, and these things can be analyzed using finite element method. And you can change the parameter, you can change the strain and strain rate where after this physical simulation, and you can observe how the material behaves, what is the plastic deformation, what is the strain profile, so how it behaves, what are the defects evolves, all those things you can observe, so that so saving of economy will happen. Deform 3D, you can perform the ring rolling process, clogging process, kind of compression rolling process, and you can do forging and extrusion process. So all those things are quite possible. So this particular simulation output also analyzed by a processing map route. So how it is done, one by one example, let us see. So these are the experimental, laboratory scale experimental output data. Strain hardening, basically when you are subjected to the compression strain or compression stress, dislocations multiples when you are continuously applying the stress, and grain growth occurs at a, for example, higher temperature, above resolution temperature, and strain softening will also occur, dislocation annihilation positive and negative dislocations and anneal together and gives dislocation free grain and recrystallize grain refinement, so that the grain size comes down. So those things will also occur after autolytic process when you subject it into the annealing process, which is stain softening process. Steady state, dynamic recovery, dislocation generation, annealation balance need to be balanced. It need to be optimized, these things. These are the stress strain curves which are taken from the Journal of Alloys and Compounds in 2016 journal by author called Saxena and other authors. True stress and true strain. So these 0.1, 0.2, these are the true strain values. True stress in megapascal 50, 100, 150, it goes to the 300. So in the case of, for example, aluminium alloys, it is done at 750 degrees Celsius temperature, it is done at 92 degrees temperature. So what is the stress strain profile? Stress strain curves are the initial data for constituting an equation, so that you can fit it in the finite element method. You can further, you can change the temperature, strain rate, this particular deformation percentage, 0.01, 0.1 percentage. These are the deformation percentage by art rolling process, art forging, or non-conventional process such as ECAP process. These are the percentages. So how it changes, you can study. This data is helpful to develop a constituent equation. So what actually you need, so you need to establish a response of a material to the external stimuli. When you apply a load, so it gives a strain, so which develops a relation between applied stress, strain rate and temperature. This can be done by either phenomenological, means by laboratory experiments, or from the first principle with respect to the atoms and electrons and protons, neutron simulations, proton simulations, electron simulations. You can develop a equation. In the case of thermomechanical processing, so it is usually observed that the stress is a function of strain, strain rate and temperature, and there is also relation between the strain and strain rate and strain rate and temperature. For example, in the case of creep, it is high temperature strain, temperature high and strains, strains are slow strains are given, so which is nothing but less than 10 power minus 7 second per second. And super plasticity, such as severe plastic deformation in the case of ECAP, 10 power minus 5 second per second, this much strains are developed. In the case of conventional thermomechanical processes, the strains are 10. So for example, 10 micrometers per second, 10 micrometer changes. In the case of strain means dimensional change, it could be the area change, length, 10 micrometer length changed per second. So in the case of ballistic simulations, means molecular dynamic simulations, where you study proton simulations, neutron simulation, when it is been subjected to the n number of protons, n number of neutrons on the sample, so how it deforms plastically. So that is for a second, 10 to the power of 2 picoseconds or picometer dimensional change will occur. So those are the important parameters one need to know. So one of the example, you constitute an equation from the processes or to develop a model, and you can predict the forces. For example, strain rate equal to this Arrhenius constant and sin h, alpha is the thermal expansion and sigma is the stress, n is the strain rate sensitivity, and exponential of minus q by rt, q is the activation energy, r is the gas constant, t is the temperature in degree Kelvin, so in Kelvin temperature. So this is one of the equation which is suitable for the art rolling, art forging process. Now coming to the, how do you analyze this output of the simulation process? Using a processing map, So most of the industries required. So it put a challenge. You need to develop a window or a technique. You need to optimize for this process to get good formability sheets of car outer body. So it should not any defect, should not have any defects, and finer grain size, eye strength and eye toughness. So how do you know? So I want to know this particular parameters of strain and strain rate and temperature for the processing of hot forging. So how do you, this particular processing maps are helpful. So in this particular situation, for example, choose high efficiency around 10 power minus 2 per second, 708.75. This is one of the, for the aluminum alloys, this processing map, logarithmic, so natural logarithmic of strain rate and temperature, and choose these particular parameters or these parameters to avoid the instability. So this dashed lines somewhere in the discontinuity is because of the instability, some defects which are developed. So after developing the process map, you will choose. So I will choose this particular temperature range and this particular strain and strain rate value. Strain rate values 0 and 0.5, 1. And minus 0.5, minus 1, minus 1.5, minus 2. And this is for the compression strains. This is for the tensile strains. I will choose this particular temperature range of 650 to 750 for the strain values of 0.050. 0.090 strains at 0.12 strains. I will choose this particular parameters for getting the large strength and toughness values. So these are the useful. So you will process, you will explain these particular simulations by taking one of the example process in the future lectures. Now let me conclude this particular today lecture. Write down the following answers. What are the conventional and non-conventional thermomechanical processes exist? And how to get the initial data such as strain rate, temperature, strain values from any TMP, thermomechanical process, to develop a model. So you need to perform a laboratory scale of experiments, one of the int for this question. How to predict the process parameters through various simulations? How do you predict? So what parameter need to be done, for what temperature range to be chosen, what strain rates, what strain values are chosen? How do you optimize? So how do you predict? So what are the simulation models? So such as int, such as finite elemental methods, deform 3D, so all those things, solid works, and how to define the boundary conditions. So all this dimension, x direction, y direction, z direction change. So what are the boundary conditions are required? How do you develop? So thank you.